Well, here is a garden update in Nashville, Tennessee from Steve Hall. It goes out to my brother Larry Hall up in Brainerd, Minnesota. I had a couple of bad plants. This one right here and that one right there. Two of them that I had got at an independent nursery, and I don't know why, but they got yellow leaves and kind of croaked. So I went and got two more from Home Depot and put them in there. And the Home Depot plants, whatever supplier they're using, seems to be working good. But be careful when you go to replace a plant, because you end up buying thornless raspberries. Now I got two actual kind of potted groups of raspberries in there, which is probably way too much for this pot. Although I drilled some holes about 3 inches up from the bottom, kind of turned it into its own self-watering tub. And that way when I poured water, I soaked it real good and all the excess ran out of them three holes across the bottom. And I'm gonna get another couple of grow bags on Monday, and I'm going to split this in half and put half this group in one big grow bag and half of it in the other. Now I did have a request from a viewer that was watching them, because I mentioned mosquito dunks about, you know, and they want to know if it poisoned the water or poisoned the plant or whatever. And this is the actual brand that I bought, and you can see I've only taken two of them out here, and these are mosquito dunks. It kills mosquitoes before they're old enough to bite, and it's for our organic production. And it says it can be used in fish habitats, like if you got a fish pond with fish in it there, you know, flower pots, tree holes, bird baths, rain gutters, old tires, animal watering troughs. So it's pretty much safe for plants and animals. They don't really want you to use it in drinking water if it's, you know, for some reason you're going to use that for direct drinking water. I don't know why, but it seems safe enough to me. And it says on the back here that the it doesn't matter if it gets wet and then goes dry and gets wet again. It doesn't affect the effectiveness of it. And it says that the larvae that are growing in there, they drink or eat that them little dunks. And what you do is you break them up in little chunks and put them on top of the water. They want you, they make sure, they say don't breathe the dust from this stuff or get any on your clothes. Wash your hands real good. So I mean, I hope that don't scare some people off. It doesn't seem to bother the plants at all. My brother Larry said he uses them year after year, and they just zap all the skeeters, so they do real good. But that's it. It comes in a red package, and it says one dunk does 100 square feet. Well, now that's 10 feet by 10 feet equals 100 square feet. So I sat that in my mind, and I thought, if I put all these tubs together side by side, 10 foot by 10 foot, would be about how much surface water there is in all of these little tubs combined. So I just took one and broke it into little teeny pieces that I could and plunked those pieces. And it says you can break up the pieces on the back of here, like 1 to 5 square feet, a quarter of a dunk, 5 to 25 square feet, a half a dunk, you know, that kind of thing. You just put a little chunk in there, I guarantee it'll wipe out the skeeds. Or if you have any problem with it, you can always fill that full of rock, like my brother Larry does. Or he says once in a while, and this is really crazy, he says once in a while I just let it run dry. He said I let the container run completely dry, and that kills every mosquito in there. He said, and then I fill it up again. So that's one other option if you don't want to do it. But I didn't have quite enough pieces to get to every tub, so I broke up another one and kind of chunked them in there. So I hope that answers your question there. Mosquito dunks kills mosquitoes. And I got this at either Home Depot, I think I got it at Home Depot, and or at the hydroponic store, one of the two. But that's the brand right there. I guess it's Biological Mosquito Control, and it says it's by Summit brand, it says down at the bottom there. But they're in that red package, and it's good for fish ponds and everything. So apparently if you got a little outdoor fish pond and you don't want any skeeters, just chuck one of them in there, and they float to the surface, and the larvae that are on the surface eat that little powder, and it zaps them. So but apparently it's safe for your pets, like if you got big watering dishes outside and you want to keep the skeeters out of there, but the dogs can still drink it. Apparently it's not tough enough to rough them up. So there you go. I hope that answers your question. And this is Steve in Nashville saying, I hope your garden's growing like mine, because it's going crazy. And when I bought these raspberries, so they already had tons of raspberries on them. So they must be second year generation stuff. They're already producing fruit. And they said once the fruit produces, prune those ones that fruited off, and then they'll come out all other kind of places and stuff. So everything else is looking great, man. All my cucumbers are growing great, and the peppers back there are doing awesome. The tomato plants are just beyond beyond anything. And I just noticed this is the first thing. I thought these little pods here were going to turn into a berry, and apparently they are, but they're turning into a flower first. This is the first flower of these huge blackberry bush tree kind of looking things. I don't know where I bought them. I think I bought them at Walmart or something, because they were there, or either that or Home Depot, because they were thornless. And I kept my little thorny suckers out front to keep so we could get blackberries last year. Now that we got the thornless, we chucked them. But there's four big thornless ones, and I noticed that's the first bloom to pop open. So this whole thing's going to be all pretty flowers first, and then blackberries coming out of the middle, I hope. We'll see. We'll give you an update as we move towards it. Talk to you later. Steve Hall in Nashville checking off with my brother Larry Hall in Brainerd, Minnesota. Bye-bye.